I feel so naughty. There's a trick to these. Good afternoon, afterballs. I'm thinker than you drunk I am. Yes, Mum. I'm breaking into a cop shop. Ha! Lovely. Come on, people. Time to get some fresh air. Come on out. You look terrible. At least they weren't down the back of a sofa. I could... This lot will do for the boys of the crab. Hello, gorgeous. Come to JJ. Yeah.
What's up?
C'est moi, babe.
Kai, you gonna take your pick of the guns or what?
A pass for now. Only gun I want is a drone I'm piloting miles away from the action.
You must be exhausted. Come, rest. Those devils will still be there when you go back out. If any of us...
Oh, hey! You got me the tapes, didn't you?
You still don't remember my name, do you?
Hey, thanks to you, I'm on my way back up, man. Those samples and old ideas are gonna be part of a new album, man! Big themes, big riffs, sex, death, undeath, badass lyrics! Well, I'm a little out of practice with lyrics, I'm not gonna lie.
Did you have a point you wanted to make, or are you just dreaming out loud?
Screaming fans, screaming guitars! Oh, hey! I gotta go to my place and get Chopper. The apocalypse needs a soundtrack, man, and Ricky Rex is gonna ride with the horsemen!
Let's assume Chopper is a guitar, not something sordid. And let's say I could go get it for you.
Oh, yeah? Oh, killer! Cause I got this song we're running, and I gotta keep hold of it. Oh, you need to find Misha. Chopper's locked away upstairs at my place. You gotta be careful. Cause this one time, when we didn't lock up, when the party finished, the whole upstairs was, like, empty. Totally cleaned out. And so, yeah, Misha, she had the key.
Right, Misha. So many fucking names to remember. You think the end of civilization would remove the need for a contact list?
You best go around the back through the kitchen. Oh, and if the band are there and, you know, milking their encore, could you send them up to the big gig in the sky?
I'll probably just kill them. No time for metaphysical logistics.
You look like someone well-versed in matters of the grotesque.
You're no oil painter yourself, sister.
I can see that you're begging to ask, so I'll tell you. Yes, I am an artiste, a sculptor of perceptions, of minds, of reality itself. Francesca.
Sorry, I'm not in the market. NFTs is the thing now.
Since the dawn of humankind, art has challenged us and elevated us. Now more than ever, it is art that will save us from our moral decay.
You want to help save people, don't you?
Well, that's a broad brush. Define people. Some might say that.
Then go out and collect me infected flesh. You can rip it straight from any of those mindless conformists wandering around. Or perhaps you already have some to donate. When you've got enough, put it in that bucket there.
Charming knack for mental imagery you got there, Francesca. One question. Why in God's name?
Oh, how can you be so obtuse? I'm creating my magnum opus, my masterwork. I am Michelangelo, and you must bring me the finest vein marble. Now, go!
Madness. By its thematic.
Get on with it. Throw what you've got in the bucket. The process can begin. The sublime pain and sacred pleasure of new creative birth.
Or you could paint some flowers. A sunset, maybe. Feet up by tea time.
My God, we've barely begun.
I need rarer, more exquisite parts. I've been listening to the inane chatter on the radio. I've heard of marvelous, monstrous beasts around the city.
I must mold their fantastical corruption.
You know, there is a point in every man's life where you must look at yourself in the mirror's eye and declare, tonight I'm going to net the whole blotter.
Mark this. My artistic flow is paramount. I'll place my requests on the board up there. When you bring the matter, do not interrupt me. Just drop it in the bucket.
The bucket? The bucket?
We can trade for my aesthetic leftovers, but as I pass you the dregs of my creativity, consider what residue of your own will you discard. Don't answer. Just let that stew for a while.
I made a bet with myself you'd have something to give me the next time you came by. I really don't want to lose.
Go out and bring me something fabulous from those monstrosities.
Leave me alone. I'm just suffering from artist's block. I'll be fine.
Party's over. Fuck off home. This is a rock legend's crib. Nice venue. Look at those views. Aisha. Ricky said she had the key. So, to lure her out.
Welcome to the Gods and Whiskey Farewell Tour. Oh, bollocks. Here they come. The janky remains of Gods and Whiskey. Ricky says hi. Belong to me. You know, there's something about staying to a beat. It actually helps. Way to split up, I guess. Creative differences. You're late, Misha. We had to start without you. Misha, you have been disbanded. One key. Lovely. Fabled upstairs. It's got to be bursting with loot. So the chopper, surely an axe guitar, or a ukulele with attitude. disabled chopper. Generally, I'm a completionist, but the gods of whiskey slaughter would have to stop a Ricky. For now.
Chopper! Killer! This is it, New Dawn. Oh, did you, were the band...
It was an escalator to heaven moment.
That's... they would have wanted that. I'm gonna write them a song for the new album. Slam to the Slaughter.
You've started a new album?
Yeah, check this out. One man and one woman, and her pain in the ass daughter, on a quest through the apocalypse to put a band together. Playing music so spine-shakingly epic, the zombies' heads literally explode!
Jesse would make an awesome manager.
Yeah, that works. Another new start. Hey, you really helped me out. Oh, I got this big sword I used on the Knights of the Sound Fable tour. You want it?
If it ain't fake, yeah. Gods and whiskey.
Ricky Meggs is back, man! I haven't felt like this in years!
Gods and whiskey.
The King of Rock will rise again.
Well, that sounds like something his queen needs to take care of, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah? Well, what would her ladyness suggest?
I think I ought to play a fanfare on the royal trumpet. To announce that the king is coming.
Oh, I fucking love you, babe. Shall we adjourn to the royal bed place?
As soon as we...
radio. Wait, aren't you...
Yes, my expression. Yes, I am wearing my green card up, and I guess this is a bad time.
Wow. Captain Vixen.
Damn that useless chunk of... Ugh! There's more coming, be careful.
Captain Vixen, I represent the people of Londinium 12. How may I be of assistance?
Never expected you to actually show up. You're really going to help look for Sebastian?
My people are but simple wretches, destined to perish attempting hopeless acts of kindness.
He's a skinny kid, no fighter, but he's tricky, creative. It's how he's made it this far. Problem is, I can't reach him on the radio, and his stupid DD toy keeps drawing in the zombies.
That plucky beeping coming from your bag.
DD-09, Space Fox's nav droid and baby robot merchandise milker. Can't stand the thing. But Sebastian loved it enough that he made a replica for conventions. I have no damn clue how to shut it up. If he doesn't get back and do something about it soon, our safe zone will be overrun.
Then let the mountain come to Mohammed. I'll take DD to Sebastian.
You can clearly take care of yourself. Fine, you take DD. Start your search in Soundstage 3. I'll keep looking out here in peace. Just don't lose that bag. Lost enough as it is.
Don't worry, Dee Dee. We'll find Seb. Just keep it down, okay? Delay the beeping, Dee Dee. Desist. We need to plot another jump. We won't find Sebastian here. Thank you. comically timed interjections, Dee Dee? And he hasn't been turned into a small pile of grey dust, or sprayed by hypnotic...
Why is DD09 acting like this? I can check on it, but not until those body snatchers are dealt with. So where's Mr. Shepard? And why do you have my robot? And on that note, why are you here? And also, who even are you?
Well met. I'm JJ. No, not that one. Captain Vixen sent me.
So the captain sent you? But I'm fine. I'm just scavenging for tools and parts. Nothing to worry about.
The challenge is that Dee Dee here won't shut up. It's acting like a zomboid beacon. We need a stealth mode if possible.
Oh, jeez. I really screwed up. This is beyond cringe. My dumb robot nearly got Mr. Shepard killed. I can't show my face around her no more. She's gonna hate me.
Ensign Bastion, this is not the time for self-indulgence. Your captain requires that you restrain Dee Dee and report in.
You're right. I'll fix DD09 up and return to camp. But please, take something for helping Captain Vixen today. Consider it your spoils of war, and may the Star of Volpine guide you.
Captain, Ensign Bastion has been found exploring Stage 6. He is well.
Ah, I can't thank you enough for this. If you ever need to take a break, you're welcome to join us behind a big green screen. I'm keeping the area safe.
Greetings, Traveler. I'm pleased to report that we have safely regrouped.
Jolly good, Ensign. As you were.
Sebastian, don't get distracted. Running out there alone was incredibly stupid. Do not do that again.
It was a necessary risk, Captain. I found enough parts that we can start.
Power lever for the whole floor. Okay, Rav. Hannah said you were here somewhere.
Oh, hey! Hey! Up here! Balcony!
Hey, Rav! Hannah called us on Pocketip's helpline. You'd like some help?
Yes! So Hannah got at least part of my message. I'm glad you're here. I was only halfway done.
You'll be halfway done in a minute, old lad, if you don't follow me out of here.
I don't need an escort. I need data. A paramedic friend told me her ambulance got requisitioned to transport barrels here. The soldier said it was stuff to fuck up the zombies.
What kind of stuff?
That's what I need to find out. There were scientists here. I found their workspace, but zombies found me and treated me up like a cat. I need to look at their notes, see if this weapon is something us Bobcats can use.
Or something all of us can use. Okay, I'll have a nose around the ambulance. And we need to clear out these zombies. You know, this place has a DJ set up.
Music! Loud music! Yes! Okay, I'm good with tech. I'll make this work. Let me know when you're on your way back.
Hey, Rav, there's a Thunderball out here, so I'll be a couple of minutes longer.
Got it. I'm in a vent now on my way to the workroom. I powered up the DJ setup by the stage in the ballroom. It's ready when you are.
Be with you in a jiffy.
Toxic puke. The flights are adapting their weapons off as well. I hit my second affair. I'm gonna settle on the dissecting table.
Okay, I had a hunch, but I needed to be sure. This stuff is an alkali called Caustic X. They've been making people soup all over the valley and flushing it down the drains.
That's surprisingly smart, actually. I was experimenting with acid, but it dissolved my weapons. They went alkaline instead. And I bet they used it a live one. We're going to the DJ setup here. Come drop the beat so I can get at their notes.
I'll put my dancing socks on.
While they're heading to you, I'll get what I can.
Music to disembowel to. Home for tea and cake.
Caustic X works, more or less. But it shouldn't work as fast as they think it does. Up for some fieldwork?
If it involves stupendous violence, I guess the tea and cake could wait.
Loving the attitude. Baller as hell, no cap. And yes, it does. I need you to use that solvent to kill zombies. You said they filled up the pool, and I'll observe from the top floor.
And compose a heroic account of my delayed gratification?
It's not science unless you write it down. Well-known fact.
And it's not an heroic accomplishment without tea and cake. Remember that.
Caustic
Hey, Rev, I've assumed the position.
I am good to go. Begin performing the science.
By that, you mean boot hamheads into the pool?
If you wouldn't mind.
Hell on wheels, you know that? Fucking pleasure to watch. I checked back in with Hannah and everything's cool now. Thanks for your help.
That's what the Zompocalypse helpline is for. Please give me 5 stars.
Now I know it works. It should be simple to causticify a weapon for maximum melting instead of using acid. Until I do, though, here, to the victor go the toys.
Ooh, I just got a naughty tingle in me dancing socks.
I'll head back to the canals and apply what we found here. We're all in an arms race now, and we have to win it.
Where are the stairs?
Thank you. I just can't believe he's gone. My side whenever I needed anything. God, I used to make him pick up my dog's poos.
Now there's a sight for sore eyes.
Hello, Mr. Sinclair. Mum says hi. It's much more relaxing here, eh?
Company's a marked improvement here. That's for damn sure. Just a pity that the tasteful Miss John left the stocking of the liquor cabinet to her tasteless hound of a husband. Ha ha ha!
New money just ain't got the style of the classics like you and me.
Why settle for less, I say? These good people welcome me into their home. They deserve the best. And I happen to know that slacker up the hill was holding on to some vintage hard-killing whiskey as an investment. And when those internet kids moved in, I gave them a bottle of Maison Saint-Vivant that's older than they are. If only some kind soul would help an old man out. I could raise everyone's spirits.
Or we could keep it to ourselves, eh?
Get me those drinks, and I swear to you, I'll make it worth your time. I've got something special that'll make those meaty-mouthed, undead bastards slither back into their graves.
So, I get the quality booze, bring it back, we drink said booze, whilst you show off your impressive weapon. No giggling in the back row.
I knew I could rely on you, kid. Godspeed. Miss Salazar. What a woman.
It's gone again.
If this were my gaff, would I keep our kid in single malt in the cellar? Sports room? Bedside table? Mouthwash bottle? Nada. Maybe if I fashion a totes awesome whiskey detector from scrap and bandages. and it... empty. Sucked dry. As if a huge, whiskey-supping zombie has... No, Che. Don't get paranoid. Not a result. Next. Of course you'll have the key. A blend. Ugh. Success! Boom. Art killing. Lovely. Mindset. Start at the bottom and work up. Cooking wine. Cooking wine. Piss water. Et voila. Uber plonk. Get in.
You there, kid? If you're still down at that modern mansion, look out for a cigar box. The finest Cuban. Gave them as a housewarming gift, and I got a hankering.
Mr. Sinclair, even during the zompocalypse, I'm reticent about burglary.
Then I'll sweeten the deal. Check their master bedroom, and you'll find a little something extra.
Mr. Sinclair, your order is being processed. Goodies for big game hunter Licky Guts, you say? Locked away by the mailman for safety. Now, where'd he get to? Usually, I only run errands for my mum.
You're too good to me, kid. And don't let anyone say that Curtis Sinclair is not a man of his word. You take my rifle, P. And for the cigars, I'll throw in some ammunition to get you started.
But Mr. Sinclair, your hands are neither cold nor dead.
Old Peggy's done right by me over the years, but my joints can't handle her kickback no more. Treat her right, and she'll look after you, too.
My mom is flipping angelic cartwheels right now. But what about you?
No need to worry about me, kid. They can try and bite me. My hide's tougher than a $2 steak. Besides, I can still handle a pistol just fine. I'll be all right with Peggy's little sister, Betty, on my hip. I thought I'd seen it all.
Hello, fella.
Oh, you came.
You were right, old lad. The zombie gunk is disturbingly effective. Don't know how you figured that out.
Oh, well, if you want to see how things work, you have to take them apart, you know?
And I'm getting very good at taking them apart. You're a star, old lad. Just like Jordan. Now, dude, there's something awful growing down here.
Sometimes.
That's the shit I'm talking about. Word of advice, stay well away. Abandoning a sinking shit. Thank you.
find one of those things that burst through my window at night and start gnawing at my face.
They said this all skull.
And so that's how I dropped out. At a law school.
Sarah Shepard.
Another controversial beachfront development.
Anybody home? Zulu, don't surf!
Lovely. So, the quarantine corridor to the lifeguard tower. Decor could be more inviting. 3 stars.
Locked down. What would Captain Ellie Vixen do? Command, override!
Here we go. Stay frosty, Jay. Reception was up that bath. 2 stars. Wednesday. That's the last day. Fellow on duty was Hicks. So, corpse or zombie? Corpse or zombie? Come on, Hicks, where are you? Excuse me? Not our boy. Sorry. Sorry. Not the sausage. Nope. Jacob Nielpoint. Not a sausage. More of the code. Still gotta find Hicks, or at least his tags. And he had a bad tum. Potty time. Lovely. One masterful. Set phasers to exfoliate. Jacob.
This is Warrant Officer Rodriguez. You should turn around, dumbass. That corridor is not secure. It's your funeral. Out.
Funeral, schmuneral. Once more onto the beach. Is mine, and mine's a toss alone.
really doing it. Well, good luck, and give him hell for...
No doubt. Anything I should know?
I'm not gonna lie. It's tough beyond this gate.
Any more detail? Numbers? Sizes? I mean, I can wing it, but... Rabbit soup, coming up. Sterling Hotel, Dr. Reed, and a CDC seat out of here. Thank you. Ocean Avenue. The Serling Hotel must be close. This green zone is looking nice and quiet. The Serling Hotel. At last. Signs of survivors. Awesome. I can almost smell that crisp laundry. Steady, I'm human. An enchanting company.
Oh, you are, huh? You're not here to eat us, then?
There isn't enough ketchup in the world.
Comedian, huh? They look human to you.
So-so.
Well, okay, then. Humans can be redeemed. Don't need to waste the bullet on this one. Hey, keep up the good work, Denise. Hey, I'm Dr. Reed, but you can call me Reuben. Let's talk in my office.
We spoke on the radio about the vaccine.
Shh, buck with me. I'm glad you made it. Really glad, but we gotta keep your specialness on the down low. If you really are what we've been looking for, then CDC's gonna want to talk to you.
Doctor, he doesn't want to take his shot.
Wait, Luther? Hey, don't worry. It's just gonna pinch a bit. Let's keep walking. Where was I,
CDC's going to...
CDC, right. The CDC's going... Hey, I told you to stay off that foot. You want me to cut it off? Come on. Hey, come this way. Now.
So glad you're here. Now they're gonna send a chapter to pick you up and take you to Colorado. Just you. So I don't want my people here getting hope when they got none. You understand?
None. I wasn't expecting that.
Oh, we'll be okay. Follow the 9 times and you get up 10. That's what I always say. But you got a miracle in your blood. If we can get you to Colorado, humanity has a chance.
Okay. So you call a chopper or?
Well, I need to let know you're here first and then I, yeah.
We're out of food. We need to sweep those apartments before someone else comes out.
No, Tisha, we gotta put that on hold. This person here is our new priority.
Hey, Jacob.
They're more important than people starving?
Yeah, kind of. I can't really talk about it right now, but...
That's fine. Look, you stay here. I'm gonna go with these guys. Hey, be back soon.
Hey, you do not go outside without me. They can handle it.
Hey, Doc, you know we ran out of food. What's the plan?
Dad, I am not a little girl anymore. I have to do my share.
Yeah, obviously you've lost your mind. There are terrorists out there.
I just let her go, Doc. She wants me to be 17.
Jimmy, I am talking to my daughter.
I'm sick of talking. Jimmy's right. I need to do something.
After all that's happened, she's gonna let you out of my sight. She's not gonna let you turn into one of them like your mother.
Oh, no.
Tisha, I'm sorry, but I can't lose you two.
You're right, Dad. I shouldn't put this on you. It's not fair.
Well, okay, then. Come on.
See you later.
Yeah. This is no place for human beings.
Hey, Doc, a word of advice. You want to stay top dog? You let your daughter take her chances just like everyone else.
Jimmy, I have got enough things to be focusing on without your bullshit.
Sure. Yeah. I'm gonna go for a smoke.
Yeah, you do that.
The fuck you looking at?
Don't make me say it, John.
I need to radio CDC, but I don't want to draw too much attention to you, so... Look, you make yourself at home, and I should have some good news soon.
Okay? I'm knackered. I could sleep for a week. Oh, I could murder a full English.